Next of our panelists is Srikanth Vinnakota. He is the founder of Analog IAS Academy. He has completed schooling at in Nagarjuna Sagar. He did Bachelor of Mechanical Engineering from OU. Since childhood, he wanted to become IAS officer. In fact, chosen to join engineering for the sake of becoming IAS because in 1992, most of those who became IAS were engineers. Soon after completing BE, he did ME from OU, during which he prepared for civil services exam. He went till interview 3 times, but could not make it to service. Meanwhile, to share his knowledge of mathematics, which was his optional subject in civils exams, he started his own academy called Analog IAS Academy. Till today.
The thing is, being an entrepreneur is something which I never thought of, actually. And in fact, an accidental entrepreneur. To be frank with you guys, it's the same hall when I was studying my engineering, my third year, I think. There was one workshop which was held in the same premises about entrepreneurship. And there was one teacher called J.V. Subramaniam, sir. I think most of you might be knowing. Sir was talking about entrepreneurship, and the only thing that I understood was most of the things I could not understand in that, but one thing which I could recollect is he was talking about how to pronounce the word entrepreneurship or entrepreneurship. After that, I could not understand anything whatever he spoke. The point is, today after so many years, I'm talking about the same entrepreneurship here. In fact, throughout my life, I never thought that I should become an entrepreneur, number one. Number two, I never thought that I should start a business or I should maybe like become an entrepreneur and start my own business and be successful in the business is something which is outside my scope, actually. Because my father, right from my childhood, he was talking about Srikanth, he should become IPS officer, initially. Later on, he said like, no, he should become IAS officer because you have got all the skills of becoming an IAS officer. Now, one fine day, he told me that, Srikanth, you have got very good mathematics skills, so you should become an engineer. Now, I was in a surprise situation because after plus two level, which way I should go now? And one day, since he being a commerce teacher, he wanted me to become a CA again. How come so many things, I cannot do so many things? But finally, one thing which was in my mind was I should become IAS. Whether you become an engineer and become IAS or you go to a BCom and a CA and then become IAS is something which you have to decide. Then myself and my father together and we analyzed one magazine. Which is something, a CSR magazine, Competition Success Review. I don't know, this generation might not be knowing about this, but there used to be one magazine called as Competition Success Review. It's still there, yes. Yeah. That book, I have seen that almost 20 toppers of that year civil services exam results, 20 toppers were interviewed in that, of which I could see 18 were engineers. One was from humanities, one was a doctor. So 18 engineers. It was in 1992. I could still remember the second All India ranker was Mr. Muhammad Iqbal. He was one of the top scorers in mathematics optional then. 540 out of 600 marks. It was huge score. Now I was trying to convince my father, Papa, see, it's like this. If you want to become an IAS officer, the best way is now become engineer so that you'll become IAS very easily because most of the engineers are becoming IAS now. Then what's the point in going for BCom and then CA and then become IAS? What's the use of that? You'll be wasting my time. So engineering is just 4 years. Let me go for engineering and after 1 year, I'll become IAS. My father was convinced. Okay, fine. Go for engineering. So I joined OU campus then, mechanical engineering. Now, all 4 years, I thought of preparing for the examination, which I never did because, you know, our engineering, one day batting, you know that, right? never ever studied anything, as our friend was telling, like in engineering we always feel like the classroom is not in the actual classroom, it is on bikes and in canteens and the playgrounds. 4 years I enjoyed like anything in this campus. But one thing I learned, the most important thing, that any given kind of examination, if you want to crack that, like our one day batting, what we do for one day batting, next day suppose you have a test, today we start preparing for our exam and we know what is the syllabus, we know what we have to read, we read everything, keep it in your mind, next day morning you dump everything. Of course, whether the question is, you know the question or not, you will dump something. The best part is everyone passes. Okay. See, something, somewhere or the other, you have a trick there. That for this kind of an examination, this is how you have to prepare. For a civil services kind of examination, how you have to prepare is something, if you really understand that, cracking that in the very first time may not be so difficult affair. That's what I realized. And in fact, when I started preparing for this examination, really I was going according to the same line. That this examination requires this one, therefore you prepare this one, you'll get into that. But in reality, it's not like that. Your academic examination, yes, it goes that way. But in competitive examinations, the things are different. You have to learn different skills, apart from what you think is correct. And that is completely or altogether a different skill that you have to learn to compete in this world. Unless you learn that, you cannot crack any such examination. By the way, let me come to the point actually, entrepreneurship. Since my father doesn't want me to become a businessman, so I never thought of it. But somewhere or the other, in writing this examination, there's a lot of time where you feel like I'm wasting my time. Because once you write mains examination, see, this examination have prelims, mains and interview. Lot of gap would be there between different exams, especially mains and interview. You feel bored of reading same thing again and again. So you feel like, let me use my knowledge, let me share my knowledge. So I started teaching elsewhere, there I was successful, therefore people said like, Srikanth, you can start your venture also. I just started a mathematics institute to teach for civil services, that's it, nothing else. I don't want to become a businessman, I don't want to earn money, I just want to pass my time teaching others. That was the agenda for me at that point of time. Initially it was a big hit actually, because no one teaches mathematics for civil services. Throughout India I was the only person who was teaching mathematics then. No one has the guts to teach mathematics. But still I was taking that because I thought like, it's my passion, maths is my passion, so let me teach that. And I too have the guts to teach also for civil services. I started and it was a big hit. And when I started for group 1, APPSC group 1 exam, then it was a combined AP. Hundreds and hundreds of students joined, so much I earned, but finally I was not happy because I don't want to earn money actually. Earning money is not my deal. Once I exhausted all my attempts in civil services, though I was earning huge compared to all those my friends who were, and suppose someone of my friend earning lakh per month, I was earning 5 lakhs per month at that time. I'm talking about 2003, 2004. But when it comes to marriage, my father told me, Srikanth, we tried for so many alliances, but none of them are accepting you. I was earning hugely, but still none of them was accepting. You know why? Because I was running a business. At that point of time, all girls, even the parents of the girls, they wanted an IT professional, not a businessman. Business, one day it might be successful, other day it might not be. But if it is an IT, so craze at that point of time, it was IT craze like anything. Most of my seniors went to US for IT. Most of my friends, most of my juniors were into IT. But still, I felt like, no, that's not my cup of tea. But I don't have a choice. I was forced to go to IT. And after getting married, I came back actually. Because my passion was not IT. Though I was very successful in IT. Came back, just resigned just like that after getting married. Just like that. My wife was like, what the hell are you doing? I don't want to marry a teacher. I want to marry an IT professional who would take me to US. That was the case at that point of time. Today, of course, things have changed. But the point is, yeah. But the point I would like to make here is, if you want to become an entrepreneur, first thing that you have to understand is that, listen to your heart, not to this one. Here, this tells you about your skill set, but this tells you about your passion to do something. I don't want to become a teacher at one point of time, but at some point of time, I realized when I was in IT, it's not IT which is going to be my career in future. It should be teaching which should be my career. Because I listened to my heart at that point of time. It was somewhere in 2009 or something like that. I realized, now in teaching, since I have passion, let me resign my IT job, just like that. I resigned, came back, and I revived my own institute. Okay? That is the time where I realized this, yes, entrepreneurship is something which I have to do now. And I enlarged my business to the extent that today, hundreds and hundreds of students are coming to my academy and getting trained, and hundreds of them become IAS and IPS. And today, we have grown to the extent like throughout India, everyone knows our name. Everyone knows that. And I'm so happy for that, that I don't have any regrets for what I have done earlier, that I resigned my IT job, or my wife was not so happy earlier, but today she is the most happiest person. So entrepreneurship is something like that. Always listen to your heart. Don't listen to this one. Always listen to this one. Okay? Thank you. Always believed in the passion to do something, because I always believe in my, believing in my heart, not my brain basically. Okay, because I never believe my brain. I always believe my heart. So my heart wants something, then I will just go with that. And if it want to, yes, Srikanth, you go and teach, I will go and teach. If it want me to do, go and do business, I will go and do business. Because finally at the end of the day, I want to be a happier person. For that to happen, I just need to believe that yes, my heart is right. Okay, so always look at the passion where your heart really looking for. That's a place where you try to work always. Because tomorrow you might get a very good job. You might go to US or you might go to Europe and do very good IT business or maybe something else you do. But if you're not happy in that, then there is no point. At the end of the day, or maybe after 45 years or after 50 years, if you look back and see what I have achieved in my life, is that money? Is that the number of buildings that I have? Is that what I wanted in my life? Or I want a satisfaction in my life? So I would always prefer that you should have that satisfaction in your life. For that, you always listen to your heart. Number two is, always try to face some kind of risks in your life. You should have that ability to face this world is possible only if you have that ability to take risk. Taking risk in your life is very important, because don't always feel that I have a target, I have a very easiest way to reach the target. No, there is never an easiest way to reach a big target. Always there are a lot many ups and downs in that. For that, you have to take certain decisions which might be a harsh decision, but that requires you to be like, you should have that gut feeling to do that, yes, I can do this. Number two, you should have that ability to take risk, take very spontaneous decisions sometimes, which might involve some kind of a risk. So being passionate enough to do something, number two, taking risk. These two are very, very important. Of course, always one thing which always is there, trust yourself. Okay, thank you.
Thank you, Srikanth.
You can start your venture also. I just started a mathematics institute to teach for civil services. That's it, nothing else. I don't want to become a businessman. I don't want to earn money. I just want to pass my time teaching others. That was the agenda for me at that point of time. Initially, it was a big hit actually, because no one teaches mathematics for civil services. Throughout India, I was the only person who was teaching mathematics then. No one has the guts to teach mathematics. But still, I was taking that because I thought like, it's my passion. Maths is my passion. So let me teach that. And I too have the guts to teach also for civil services. I started and it was a big hit. And when I started for group 1, APPSC group 1 exam, then it was a combined AP. Hundreds and hundreds of students joined. So much I earned. But finally, I was not happy because I don't want to earn money actually. Earning money is not my deal. Once I exhausted all my attempts in civil services, though I was earning huge compared to all those my friends who were earning, suppose someone of my friend earning lakh per month, I was earning 5 lakhs per month at that time. I'm talking about 2003-2004. But when it comes to marriage, my father told me, Srikanth, we tried for so many alliances, but none of them are accepting you. I was earning hugely, but still none of them was accepting. You know why? Because I was running a business. At that point of time, all girls, even the parents of the girls, they wanted an IT professional, not a businessman. Business, one day it might be successful, other day it might not be. But if it is an IT, so craze at that point of time, it was IT craze like anything. Most of my seniors went to US for IT. Most of my friends, most of my juniors were into IT. But still, I felt like, no, that's not my cup of tea. But I don't have a choice. I was forced to go to IT. And after getting married, I came back actually. Because my passion was not IT. Though I was very successful in IT. Came back. Just resigned just like that after getting married. Just like that. My wife was like, what the hell are you doing? I don't want to marry a teacher. I want to marry an IT professional who would take me to US. That was the case at that point of time. Today, of course, things have changed. But the point is, yeah. But the point I would like to make here is, if you want to become an entrepreneur, first thing that you have to understand is that listen to your heart, not to this one. Here, this tells you about your skill set, but this tells you about your passion to do something. I don't want to become a teacher at one point of time, but at some point of time, I realized when I was in IT, it's not IT which is going to be my career in future. It should be teaching which should be my career, because I listened to my heart at that point of time. It was somewhere in 2009 or something like that. I realized, now in teaching, since I have passion, let me resign my IT job, just like that. I resigned, came back, and I revived my own institute. Okay? That is the time where I realized this, yes, entrepreneurship is something which I have to do now. And I enlarged my business to the extent that today, hundreds and hundreds of students are coming to my academy and getting trained, and hundreds of them become IAS and IPS. And today, we have grown to the extent like throughout India, everyone knows our name. Everyone knows that. And I'm so happy for that, that I don't have any regrets for what I have done earlier, that I resigned my IT job, or my wife was not so happy earlier, but today she is the most happiest person. So entrepreneurship is something like that. Always listen to your heart. Don't listen to this one. Always listen to this one. Okay? Thank you.
I would like to just mention about 2 points, because what I could see in my entire career, there are 2 things. One is, I always believed in the passion to do something, because I always believing in my heart, not my brain basically. Okay, because I never believe my brain. I always believe my heart. So my heart wants something, then I will just go with that. And if it want to, yes, Srikanth, you go and teach, I will go and teach. If it want me to go and do business, I will go and do business. Because finally, at the end of the day, I want to be a happier person. For that to happen, I just need to believe that, yes, my heart is right. Okay? So always look at the passion where your heart really looking for. That's a place where you try to work always. Because tomorrow you might get a very good job. You might go to US or you might go to Europe and do very good IT business or maybe something else you do. But if you're not happy in that, then there is no point. At the end of the day, or maybe after 45 years or after 50 years, if you look back and see what I have achieved in my life, is that money? Is that the number of buildings that I have? Is that what I wanted in my life? Or I want a satisfaction in my life? So I would always prefer that you should have that satisfaction in your life. For that, you always listen to your heart. Number 2 is, always try to face some kind of risks in your life. You should have that ability to face this world is possible only if you have that ability to take risk. Taking risk in your life is very important, because don't always feel that I have a target, I have a very easiest way to reach the target. No, there is never an easiest way to reach a big target. Always there are a lot many ups and downs in that. For that, you have to take certain decisions, which might be a harsh decision, but that requires you to be like, you should have that gut feeling to do that, yes, I can do this. Number two, you should have that ability to take risk, take very spontaneous decisions sometimes, which might involve some kind of a risk. So being passionate enough to do something, number two, taking risk, these two are very, very important. Of course, always one thing which always is there, trust yourself. Okay, thank you.
I was also in the same situation what you are today. So you know what I did? Since I want to pursue my preparation for civil services, so in my final year, as you said, I attempted GATE, you know, I just prepared for 1 month. I tested myself that whether I could crack this GATE or not, to see that whether I will be able to crack civils or not. 1 month was in fact sufficient enough to crack my GATE. Okay, number one. Number two, I had a lot of other choices, like I can go with GRE or GMAT and maybe CAT also. But the point is, I have chosen only to write GATE because I can pursue my master's also. In master's, I can start preparing for civil services again. And in master's also, instead of choosing IIT Delhi, which I got, I have chosen again Osmania University master's, ME Osmania University, that too production engineering only. But the kind of GATE rank I got, I would have got, in fact, I got even IIT Delhi, I did not join. Even here, I could have got computer science, which I did not join. I joined production engineering because all the teachers, I know them. They will give me enough time to prepare for my civil services. So I have created my own path there to prepare for civil services. Now that's what you can do. GATE is not just meant for your getting a job. Fine, if you want to get a job and you want to satisfy your parents, yes, for time being you can do that. But what is your ultimate passion? What is that you ultimately you want to become? If you want to become IAS, somewhere you have to choose that path which might even satisfy your parents or maybe yourself, but finally, it is the final destination that you want to reach. Ultimately, you have to choose that particular path which leads you to that. So you create a path for yourself. That's more important. Not that my parents want me to become get settled down. Fine. In that case, what you will do? You write some, maybe you attend some placements, get into job, or maybe some other IT company you get into job, and then after 2-3 years you might feel that maybe after 2-3 years once my parents got satisfied, I will come back and prepare for civil services, which may or may not happen. But if it does not happen, coming back and preparing for civil services, then the biggest problem would be that somewhere back of your mind it will be there always, that I thought of becoming IAS, which I am not today. After 10 years if you see and look back and see, I thought of becoming IAS, I could not because of my parents. You try to blame your parents, but it's not so. No, you cannot blame your parents. You try to choose your path, a proper path. And I have already chosen that. Though I could not become IAS is a different story. But I'm very successful, more than an IAS officer today. Just because that, not just IAS is the thing which is more important. Even if you're not IAS also, you can be very successful in your life. But you have to create that path for yourself. Thank you. For you to learn maths now? Is it really required? In order to be successful in your life, you don't require maths, right? So you always try to, I told you, right, whatever you feel like, I'm best in this one, I'm best in this one, go with that. When you are not best in some other area, don't worry about that, leave it, leave that. No, you don't need to worry about it. Wherever you feel like, yes, I'm best in that, go into that area. That's what I ultimately feel. So forget about maths, don't worry. If you want any coaching for maths, once you get into your dream job, then come back to me. I will teach you maths. Okay?
Thank you, sir.
The question that you were asking me was success and looking for passion, working for passion. So, see, I would believe this way. Success is something which you can get by any means, by different ways. But working for passion is something which gives you a lot of satisfaction, right? I work for my passion. My passion is teaching mathematics, that too only for civil services. First thing is, you can sit actually. The first thing is, see, whether you want to become IAS or your parents want you to become IAS, something you decide first. If it is you who want to become IAS, yes, that's the right choice. But if your father or your mother want you to become IAS and you don't have that passion to become IAS, there is no point in preparing for IAS now. Okay, you'll not be happy with the preparation. I don't think so you'll be successful also. Assuming that you are successful also, you cannot retain being IAS for long. Somewhere or the other, you'll resign unnecessarily, right? So if becoming IAS is your passion, then forget about all the skills required. You can get all those skills, don't worry. In the process of preparation itself, you'll get all those skills required to become IAS. There are lot many people who can mentor you, who can guide you. Lot many resources are available today. Unlike my time, wherein if you want to prepare for civil services, everyone would say that don't prepare, don't waste your time. But today it's not like that. You have so many resources available, plenty of resources. Suppose it's like this, I'll give an example. Suppose you want a green apple. My time, I never heard about green apple, forget about it. But today, if you want a green apple, you can actually go and grab that green apple. You can do that because a lot of resources are available. You don't need to get compromised like, if red apple is available, let me take red apple. If a custard apple is available, because apple is there, custard apple available, I will take custard apple. Not required. You don't need to compromise today. My time, my parents used to tell me, Srikanth, you prepare for civil services. If you don't get into IAS, at least you will become a group 1 officer or maybe a group 2 officer, maybe a group 3 officer. At least you will become some kind of a government servant. You will get some government job. That used to be my parents' agenda. But today it's not like that. Earlier it was like that because not many resources were available at that time. Today, all resources are available. You just need to grab the right resource to get your green apple. That's it. So you need to have that passion to become IAS. That's it, nothing else.
Yeah. And I'll request now Mr. Joshi to hand over the mementos to the panelists.